1970s, there was no bigger star than Gilbert O'Sullivan. In 1972, he sold more singles than Elton John and Elvis, with his biggest hit being Alone Again, naturally.
And without so much as a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God in his mercy, for if he really does exist, why did he desert me in my hour of need? I truly am indeed alone again, naturally.
Well, Gilbert O'Sullivan is touring Australia with his 50th anniversary show, and we are thrilled because he's joining us in the studio this morning. Gilbert, welcome to Studio 10.
Yes, nice to be with you.
Now, you've still got your rock star hair. It's great.
When I started out in the business, when long hair was fashionable in the late 60s, I had a pudding basin haircut, which is now very fashionable.
Yes.
So now that short hair is fashionable, I go long.
You're an absolute
rebel.
If
long hair comes back, then I'll cut it short.
That's great.
I can't believe it's been 50 years. I mean, God, you rock stars age well. I mean, the ones of you that are still alive.
It's all the tea. It's all the tea.
But that was... That song was sort of an anthem at the time.
Yeah, the wonderful thing about that is that the cover versions I get of it, the most recent being Michael Bublé and Diana Krall.
Yes.
And then Neil Diamond did a lovely version, and he wrote me a little letter, just very curious to know if I liked it. So I wrote back and said, terrible, but no.
Really?
I wrote back and thanked him for it. No, it was really nice. I think any version of your song done by anybody, it's a compliment. Mm. For example, I have a Japanese version by a heavy metal band of Alone Again, 200 miles an hour, and it's fantastic.
What they do with it, how they interpret it. Yeah, so. But look, in 2009, you said you were sick of music and were going to give it up.
No, I never said that.
Didn't you? No. Just the papers.
Touring. Yeah, just the touring.
No, just... I mean, normally a year is spent about 8 to 9 months of recording, writing. Writing the songs is the most important. And then 3 to 4 months of touring. In that 3 to 4 months, we can cover pretty much everywhere.
Yeah.
And that's why I'm really delighted to be here with my band for the first time ever.
Yeah. And did you think Alone Again would be such an anthem?
No, because the interesting thing is, when it was written, it was just another song that I liked and was happy with. Mm. And when we recorded it with another song, it's the other song everybody said should be the next single.
So
people liked
it.
But that's a good thing in a way, because if you knew it, it would be kind of, you'd expect that every time you wrote another one. So the unpredictability of the business is really good.
You hear that a lot, don't you? Even so, as a songwriter, do you know what, when you've written a song, you think, right, this is going to be a big hit, and then
you're
amazed when it flops, and then something else that you never think about.
No, that's the great thing, Joe. It keeps you on your toes, because you can never really predict. No matter how big a star you are, you can get it wrong. You must always think what you've written is good. Be happy with that. But you have no control of what will happen beyond that.
Yes, because you said that about Alone Again. You were happy with it.
Absolutely. Yeah. That, for me, is success, to write what I think is a good song. But I've no idea if it's going to be successful.
So do you write for other people?
No, I write for me.
But do you send those songs?
No, I don't. I know, but it's nice, you know, you get cover versions because of the success you had. Particularly when Alone Again was number one in America for so many weeks, then you get people, Sarah Vaughan would release an album called Alone Again, Naturally. Mm. Not necessarily because of the song, but often because of the success it achieved.
Are you still alone? With the song?
I'm happily married to a lovely Norwegian lady with two beautiful daughters who are now lovely women.
That's so good to hear, because the idea of the song is sad, like the person's alone on their own yet again.
Have you thought about doing a follow-up song, Together Again, Unnaturally? You were born Ray O'Sullivan, which is a lovely name. It doesn't quite have the same ring to it.
Well, I mean, in 67, because I created this image, the schoolboy image of cap and boots and stuff, putting Mason haircut, I called myself just Gilbert. But Gordon Mills, who managed Tom Jones and Engelbert Humperdinck, he took me on and he said, call yourself Gilbert O'Sullivan. So not a problem.
And you've also talked about your career slowing down. The 80s, as always happens, almost impossible to sustain that kind of momentum. Did you ever think, right, I'm going to throw in the towel here, or do you just keep
gigging
until you think...
There's always peaks and troughs. Never got off the treadmill. Even through difficult times, I always maintained that writing ability to sit in a room for 8 hours a day, five days a week, to try and write a good song. That's what it's all about. Without the songs, there'd be no artist.
And what about you? I've obviously got other hits that you've performed and written, but you're so well known for that one particular song. Does that ever get grinding itself? No. The fact that you just hear it again and again, or people are asking for it again and again?
Well, the interesting thing is, the most popular song of mine in, say, Spain would be a track called What's in a Kiss. The most popular song in Holland would be Nothing Rhymed. Ah. The most popular song in Japan and America would be Alone Again. In Mozambique, so I'm not too sure about, you know. So working on that one.
Now, you were going to be a graphic artist, so do you have any input into the record covers and stuff like that?
Yeah, a lot. I spent 4 years at art school. My mother was a little disappointed when I left that to go into music. But the great thing about being in art schools was that music and art are kind of combined. Yeah. A lot of musicians went to art school.
Yeah, the Rolling Stones did, I think.
Yeah, I think Ray Davies with the Kids went. I think John Lennon was at art school and stuff. So it was a good breeding ground to be a musician.
You were saying that you're touring Australia with your band for the first time. And you're super excited. Why? What do you love about touring?
Well, the wonderful thing about coming to you, of course, is we speak the same language. and I get the chance to visit the Canberra, Melbourne, and Hobart and all these places and stuff. But I'm taking my band is the big thing. For the last 10 years, we've wanted to come, but they've said things like, if you could reduce the band.
So this is your first proper tour,
I think.
So this time, Ben, the promoter, said, you can take the full band. That's what I'm excited about.
Can I just ask, I'm a massive musical nerd. Is it true that when you came to perform here this morning, there's a very specific type of electric piano that you always play on, and they don't even make it anymore, and we have to find it on Gumtree?
It's my friend, a Stratocaster. I mean, Eric Clapton, his favourite guitar, will probably be 60 years old. Paul McCartney's bass would be with that German Hofner bass, about 60 years old. I love the RD-1000. And there are very few of them now. I have three of them, which I go online to buy them. But they're very rare because the musical companies that hire music, they don't make it anymore.
No. Mm.
There is a new model of it, but it's just not as good.
What on earth is that?
I don't think that was the electric piano, but that's a piano there, and you actually had to get it on Gumtree, is that right?
That one was found here for me.
That's how we got it.
Will you take it back? Will you buy it and take it back?
That's the plan.
Right.
Could sell it on Gumtree.
Hang on. We'll take up a collection from the audience and the crew. It'll be wrong.
It might not look like much from that angle, but that is an amazing keyboard.
Gilbert, you are so kind. You're going to stay with us and perform a little later.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And just quickly, Gilbert O'Sullivan's 50th anniversary tour heads around Australia next month. Head to gilbert50tour.com.au for all the details. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Thank you.